Wow, that was a good entrance. Good day, everyone. I don't know if this is going to get muted on the stream or not. I have no idea. Anyway. Pretty good. Let's see. Let's get that audio back on. Awesome. Is everything looking good? I'm back. 2 weeks. And I've apparently lost my voice again. I lost my voice on vacation. I'm back from vacation. How is everyone? Oh, it's been so long. It feels like it's been forever. It feels like it's really been forever. Alright. It's like taking me a moment to remember how I've done everything. Here we go. Oh, how is everyone? 2 weeks on vacation. It was awesome. Didn't get sunburned, I'm surprised. Got my irradiated water. New mug. Alright. So, it's been about 2 weeks since I've played this game. Oh, I've been looking forward to it, though. Really back in the Fallout mood. Let's just jump right back in. Let's not even wait as my voice decides to give out on me. Again. My first week of vacation, my voice was just dying on me. Because I got sick. I was getting sick. Thanks to someone where my girlfriend works. Brought some sickness into the office. She got it, and then I got it. Alright. Oh yeah, Repcon. Was that where we were going? Oh yeah, we're Novak. We just, Hi, Chrissy. Oh yeah, you were carrying my armor. I think I didn't have enough. It's gonna take me a bit to get back into this. Alright, I'm carrying a lot of stuff. Oh, this is gonna take me a bit. Is that a caravan? Or that's the medical caravan down here, isn't it? Alright. It's gonna take me a bit to get my orientation back. 2 weeks, 2 weeks off of this, and I'm like struggling to get back into it.
What can I do for you? Yeah, and I need sterile medical supplies, but let's see what I have with me.
Well, there's a lot sterile out here, I'm pretty sure. Okay, she's got some stuff to sell. So apparently I'm overweight. I'm trying to like remember the state I left everything in when I left, before I left. Holy crap. I remember what I'm carrying. Service rifle. Okay. It's probably armor junk I'm carrying, right? Oh yeah, Pip's not wearing her helmet. What am I carrying? Holy crap. Oh, jeez. Bear with me. It's gonna take me a bit to get back into this. Apparently, I left myself with not much carry space. And now it's like taking me a while to remember like what all is in my inventory, what all am I carrying. I think most of it's in my weapons, isn't it? Alright. Sonic emitter, shovel, service rifle, grenade rifle, I want to keep that. Incendiary grenades, grenade rifle. Wait. Sell that. Alright. Oh yeah, I was playing with the dynamite, I remember. It's like weighing me down like by two. Got the repeater. Man, it is just... Okay, so this is... Five times seven. Just get rid of the cowboy repeater. Sure, why not? I'll find stuff again. Lucky was my 357. Okay. Let's see. Damage of 30 versus damage of 35. All right, so we sell that one. Cool. All right. Aside from the dynamite, that's really the biggest stuff I'm carrying on weapons. Could sell that. Ain't worth much. Alright. So if my first foray is back into Fallout Earth Shopping Simulator 2015. Let's see. What all am I carrying? Carrying a lot of Sparkle Quellas. I can drink those. Sunset Sarsaparillas. I can drink those. Oh, yeah. I was looking for parts. That's right.
Thanks.
Okay. I needed parts. That's why I'm carrying so much weight. All right. But it was for a schematic, wasn't it? It was for the... what was it? It was like for the junk gun, wasn't it? Don't remember. There's Red Heart statuette. What was I carrying that? Holy crap. Quest miscellaneous. This was it. Okay, read all this stuff. You haven't actually checked on radio station, Charlie. All right. The rocket launcher. This was it. This is what we were after. All right. So. Okay, vacuum leaf blower. All right, so what I have. So I've got the vacuum. Vacuum cleaner, do I have a leaf blower? I don't think I do. No, no leaf blower. A fire hose? Fire hose nozzle? No. Okay. Leaf blower, fire hose nozzle, and a conductor. Do I have a conductor? No. Alright. Need a lot of things. Alright. Let's check the inventory. We'll sell that. Yeah, she was carrying a fair amount of things. Yeah, she was carrying all the water, the pulse grenades. Well, yeah, she was carrying the missile launcher. Holy crap. Come on, Chrissy. You look better that way.
What can I do for you?
Alright, we'll sell...
Ah. Bye.
Hey, I'm back.
What can I do for you? Yeah, and I need...
I don't know why I'm losing my voice all of a sudden. I was just fine earlier. And now I'm not fine. There you go.
Thanks. Later.
Alright, so we were heading to the Repcon facility, right? That's where we were going? Oh, I got... What is this? What am I equipped with? That gun. Alright, it's that gun. It's just that gun. Right. radiation off the glowing one, but it's fine. Let's get our favorite weapon out.
Sneaking done. Fighting now.
Oh, it's all coming back to me.
Cessation of hostilities complete.
Oh yeah, I'm wearing the suit. Got the suit on. All right.
Ready? Step.
You take care of him, Chrysalis. Also, don't pass in front of me when I'm taking a shot.
Was that all? This one looks pretty tough. That's all.
Ghouls. Stick a fork in him, he's done. Oh, really?
This one looks pretty tough.
Where? I'm under caution, but oh, I bet it's up there.
Fighting over.
I'll head up there. Or we won't head up there. I can't go up there.
Sneaking done. Fighting now.
What do you mean? Where? I love you, Soup, but,
fighting over.
I feel like you're tossing up some false flags on me. How's the stream looking? Stream's looking good. Alright.
Me?
Is this really the time for it? I mean, I know I've been away for 2 weeks, but I mean, are we really doing this now? You're alright. You're like the second most favorite pair of underwear I've ever had. That guy's got a carton of cigarettes. This guy is a carton of cigarettes. What the hell killed him? Discover the source of the ghouls. Alright. Why is my voice disappearing today? I do not actually understand. My voice is fine! What frag grenades? I'll just chuck them for fun. What's this? Mine. Oh, I need a conductor. Let's see. Oh, I hate when they put items on items like this, because it's just like, carefully pick up the bottle caps, not the chessboard. Don't pick up the chessboard. Chrysalis is watching my back. Just sitting here carefully picking up check our pieces. Bottle caps. Whole time an entire ghoul army is falling down on me. Bright Brotherhood. Plasma rifle? Do I have a plasma rifle? I think I give up on my energy weapons. Damn it. Okay. I need to put Pip's helmet on. Yeah, sure, we'll take a plasma rifle. Quick save that just in case. There, Pip, now you're a freaking cyborg again. Are you a cyborg? Yeah, you're a cyborg again. Alright. Really sets out with the suit, too. Seriously, why am I losing my voice? I've not been losing my voice for days! Then I get on the stream and then just there it goes. Goodbye, voice. Oh, there was a nightkin up here. Yeah, not a plasma pistol. Big fight that went on up here. Oop, hang on. I need to keep my head on top. Okay. Can I just... There we go. Storing missiles in that little box. How much is the recharger right? Oh. It's worth nothing at all. Nothing at all. Okay. I know why I'm losing my voice. It was breakfast. Breakfast is making me lose my voice. Just had like a piece of cereal stuck in my throat. Holy crap. I didn't have much time to eat this morning. I was running very behind earlier today. Alright, is there anything down in these corners? Of course, you know I gotta look. Which is why this gameplay is gonna take freaking forever. But I have to check. My compulsiveness makes me check. Not obsessive compulsive. Not OCD, just... the compulsion to check everywhere for everything. Back here. Anything hidden back here? No. There isn't. What the hell, anything back there? Just taunt me! Put hidey holes everywhere and then not put anything in the hidey hole. That's extra cruel to me. I love it. Whee! I think I should just ran down that wall. I should have taken fall damage for that, but I think I literally just ran down the wall. Alright, so that can give me any sass about how it's daylight and the sneaking isn't worth it. Taking the shot. That was a bad shot. Bad sniper. Ghoul Grinder perk rank 1. Thank you. right in the head, too.
Just kidding.
That's not funny,
Sue. Was that all?
Alright. So I know not to eat breakfast, like, right before a stream. That was a bad idea. That's why my voice is disappearing. I like cereal bits stuck in my throat. Good cereal, but... end up, like, chewing on it all afternoon. Hello, Nina! I'm back. It's been quite a long time. Hi, how you doing? How you been? How's it going? Trying to get back into the swing of this. Well, guy's got a fork in him too, he's done. Repcon. Got my... there we go. My chat window is very slightly behind my broadcaster, so I couldn't see everything you said. It's going. How was my trip? My trip was good. I had a lot of fun. My trip was real good. Though I spent, like, the first half of it... kind of sick. Like, let's see, what was it? The week before vacation, somebody my girlfriend works with came into the office sick. Then she ended up sick for, like, the first week before vacation. Then she was mostly better. Then by the end of, did I sacrifice any orphans to Zool? Like, three, but they were hard to find. I had to orphan them first. That was a lot of work. But, yeah, so, like, the first week, we thought I avoided it. Then, when we were heading to, like, my first stop was North Carolina, because I got friends and family there. And I started getting sick. And then, that Monday I was there, I ended up being just in bed. I couldn't get out of bed. And then... the second week we went to Florida. Then I got better, like, real quick. Zool is pleased. Thank you. It was a lot of work. Guy up there. And then, yeah, I got to Florida and I, like, got better really fast. I think it was honestly the heat and the humid air that did it. Because I had, like, a bad cough and then got there and I just was, like, not coughing after a couple days. It was fun. Went to Universal, like, twice. Well, we went to Universal twice. We were going to go to Disney, but when we found out how freaking expensive it was, we decided not to. We just went to Universal instead. Did the whole park at Universal. Did one night of Halloween Horror Nights at Universal. So that was really fun.
Oop. Ready. Steady. Ready.
Chrissy. I mean, nice ass, but,
over.
Yeah, we actually did the Halloween Horror Nights. They were doing a preview for the employees, and my friend in Florida actually works at Universal. And, they were doing, like, an employee preview, and you could, like, they could bring, like, plus one and plus two. So, I mean, the park was still full. And, like, crazy wait times for everything. But, yeah, like, we went straight off the plane to, Universal. Didn't even check in at the hotel yet. Went to, Halloween Horror Nights. We only got to, like, a couple of attractions. Mainly because the wait times are freaking crazy. Even for, like, it wasn't open to, like, the general public. It was just employees and their friends. But it was still, like, crazy wait times for stuff. And plus, I was exhausted. Me and my girlfriend, we were exhausted. But it was a lot of fun. Like, the very first haunted house thing we went in scared the crap out of me. And I mean, I love that stuff. But it was, like, a really well-made one. It's like going to a haunted house that actually has a budget, which is freaking awesome. Because, like, all the makeup was great. Like, you walk through and, like, this werewolf thing is, like, popping out at you everywhere. And it actually looks freaking amazing. And, like, there's a part where you, like, went through, like, this old church area. And there were, like, zombies sitting on the pews. And I think most of them were real people, too. What's going on with the plasma? I thought... Did I not pick up the plasma right? Are you? I don't know. But yeah, like, so the zombies were, like, in great makeup, and it was, like, really freaking good. Then we went to, like, an other house that was based on The Purge. And I've never seen The Purge. And it was alright. Like, the theme of The Purge, I was told kind of what the theme of The Purge was. And it's, like, that's a really interesting movie idea and everything, but as for a haunted house, not really that great. I mean, there were some parts that were really, really good because they had some, like, good psychological effects, but really wanted to do the Walking Dead bit. We didn't have time, unfortunately. And we kind of messed up our schedule because we thought the Halloween Horror Nights was going all week, and it was going, like, it was just going on, like, weekends, and we didn't know that. So we were going to do, like, Halloween Horror Nights on, like, Monday or Tuesday night, and then we found out, oh, it's not happening. It's a little bit disappointed, but all considered, I wasn't that disappointed. It was really awesome.
Starting combat. Just kidding.
Ugh, I hate you, suit. Oh yeah, all the zombies. Zombies were great. I love zombies. I'm a zombie person. I love zombies. I love Walking Dead. I love zombie flicks. They're just like I'm fascinated by zombies. I'll search down there. Yeah, in North Carolina was just a lot of kind of hanging around. Like, that's where my mom is, that's where my sister is. My sister came back from college, like, over the weekend. We hung out. One of my friends that I've had for, like, 20 years. We hung out. I feel like I didn't get to hang out with everyone long enough, unfortunately. Especially when I ended up sick on Monday. It's like, people were wanting to see me, and it's just like, I can't get out of bed. I was, like, at the lowest of the low that day. It was fun, though, because, like, my mom kind of lives out in the woods. I mean, it's North Carolina. She kind of lives in the woods away from everyone. She has a four-wheeler. I hadn't ridden a four-wheeler for, like, ages. 15 years or more. She had a four-wheeler. Kind of taught my girlfriend how to ride it. She flooded the thing. But it's fine, because if she didn't flood it, I would have. She just happened to go first. And then after we flooded it, we learned how to not flood it, and then we were fine from then on. And then my sister has a rifle. And so we kind of gave my girlfriend, like, I called it, like, the true American experience. It's like, okay, you're in America. My sister has a rifle, you're gonna learn to shoot. So, my girlfriend.
Hey, over here. Are you listening? Go to the big room on the east side of this building and take the metal staircase all the way up. And hurry.
Sure.
Get moving.
Yeah, so we shot. Turns out I'm like terrible with a rifle. I'm actually better with a handgun, surprisingly. Because I've shot handguns before. That was like the first time I've ever shot a rifle. And I'm apparently better with handguns. I could not. I had a hard time hitting the target with that rifle. My girlfriend did really well. My sister did even better. And yeah, so we had some fun. We did some shopping. We went to like that Saturday. We spent a day at like this family fun place, which was like bowling, putt-putt, laser tag, arcade, that kind of stuff. It was really fun. I've never done laser tag before. I like smashed into a little kid, which is weird because it was like, let me take a drink. Like, it was weird because at one point it just lined up, so like it was adults versus kids in the laser tag. Oh, that's not worth nothing. And like at one point, all the kids were like going through the laser tag area like a freaking train. Like they were all just following each other, just like going through the course. And just like pointing it at you and shooting as they went by. And at one point they finally broke off. So we're running around the course and like near the end of one session, like plowed into a kid. That was fun. Carrying a lot of sunset sarsaparillas. I've never done laser tag before. That was really fun. Did bowling. Like the first half of bowling was terrible. Then I finally like got my thing back while at the end of it. Did some shopping, and then, yeah, off to Florida for, like, the second week. Did Universal twice, did... What else did we do? Went to the mall. There was a mall there. Oh, yeah, while we were there, my girlfriend's dad wanted an Apple Watch. And, because apparently getting Apple Watches was cheaper in the U.S. He like wanted an Apple Watch, and apparently getting them in the U.S. was cheaper than getting them here. Chris is just pissed off everything. That's fine. We had to go to like an Apple store in the mall. Watch for him. Like 700, what was it? Like after tax, it was like $700. Tried to rent a car, failed, only because I forgot how stupid American systems can be. Because we tried to rent a car, like, I don't have my license anymore. Because I let it expire. Well, my US license. My US license expired. Because I used to have an international license. But it expired, so I haven't bothered to get a new one here. But my girlfriend had an international license. And... we went to the car rental place in Florida. With the idea that... my girlfriend can drive, she's a good driver, but she was kind of worried about driving in the U.S. just in kind of an unfamiliar place. She's never driven in the U.S. before. I couldn't drive, so we thought, well, my friend drive. I'll just pay for the car. Well, the problem is to rent a car in the U.S., you have to have a credit card. Can't pay in cash, can't do a check, can't do a debit card. You have to pay with a credit card. And I was the only one with a credit card. So... you know, it's like, so my friend is essentially renting the car, and then it's like, okay, payment time.
Are we being watched?
I hand them my credit card, and they go, well, this isn't this person. You know, you have to rent the car with the person that's You have to pay for it on a credit card with the person that's driving it. So, yeah. Out of the three of us, I'm the only one without a driver's license, but the only one with a credit card. So we couldn't rent a car. But luckily, my friend's roommates were very, very gracious and let my friend borrow their cars quite a lot so we could be taxied around, which is very, very nice of them. Did a lot of shopping too, like to the point where barely got everything in my suitcase. Like, my girlfriend got some new clothes. I got some new clothes. I got a bunch of new shirts. I got three new shirts. All of them pony shirts. Every last one of them. In fact, I'm wearing one of them right now. Probably can't see it. Huh. It says smile every pony on it. You can't see it. Got this one at Universal because there was actually a kiosk at Universal that was selling pony stuff. And my girlfriend insisted that I buy it. Well, she bought it for me. And then I bought like two other shirts at Hot Topic because we don't have Hot Topics here. And then, let's see. I bought two Build-A-Bear plushes. I don't know why I said that weird. Bought two Build-A-Bear plushes, which was the hardest freaking decision of my life. Because at the Build-A-Bear, they have Vinyl Scratch now, which is one of my favorite ponies. They had Vinyl Scratch out, and they had her on display, and they were having a sale that was like, you could get two plushes for $35, which meant like, so one of them is $25, you get the other half off. Or, well, the other for $10, because it was, yeah, two for 35, and one pony was $25, so yeah, the second one's like $10, so it was like, oh, I can get two of them, but I've got limited suitcase space, too. I was like, I'm not gonna, because in North Carolina, I also bought a blanket. One of the things I was looking for was a My Little Pony blanket, and I found one, so that was taking up space in my luggage already, and then... So yeah, I had a decision to make because it's like, I really want vinyl. I really, really want Vinyl Scratch. But they also had some other ponies I really wanted. They had Celestia and Luna, which I didn't have, and I really wanted them too. But it's like, I only had enough space in my luggage for two ponies. So it took me forever to decide, but I eventually decided on Celestia and Luna. Really wanted that Vinyl Scratch though. If they had done Octavia, I would have definitely done Vinyl Scratch and Octavia, but they don't have Octavia. So I got Celestia and Luna. They rode back in my luggage. So I had the blanket, I had some shirts, I had a lot of pony stuff. Two plushes, the blanket, the shirt, the three shirts, and let's see, what else did I get? Oh, my friend in North Carolina got me a bunch of stuff. Like stickers and Valentines and pencils and eraser and a little bit of candy. All pony themed stuff. She got me. I don't carry that. Damn it. And then the other thing I got, this is another thing I was looking for specifically. Cause I saw, like, a couple years ago, I saw like a friend online had one and I really wanted it. And just happened to find a shop in Florida that had them. It was the only place I found them. So got that. I was protecting that thing like crazy. I would have been heartbroken if it broke on the way back. So yeah, ended up coming back with just a load of... Ended up coming back with a load of pony stuff. Like, our suitcases were packed full.
Fighting over.
They were loaded full. I know I was supposed to be going straight to that door, but... I mean, I kind of had. Oh yeah, that was another thing I got. I got the little figures. They call them blind bags because some of them do come in blind bags. There was the Flim set that had the super speedy cider squeezy 9000. Got that set too. Chrysalis, where are you off to? I kind of have to, when I go to the U.S., get pony stuff when I'm there, because it's not as popular here. You can go to a toy store here, and sometimes you'll find stuff. You'll sometimes find stuff, and they're actually kind of declining again around here. It's like I go to the toy store, and I'll see just a little bit less than I saw the last time. Very sad. There is a Build-A-Bear in Germany, though. Which isn't... Well, it's like... hour and a half drive from here? I think. And they carry some pony stuff. And I think there was a shop in the mall in Germany that had some pony stuff you don't normally see around here. But yeah. It's like U.S. trips... This was like my second U.S. trip in the past few years, and the time before I went to the U.S., filled my suitcase with pony stuff. I got a bunch of figures, ended up with a bunch of stuff. Alright, public kitchen. To all Repcon employees. Hello everyone, please remember that the kitchen is a privilege and not a right. Please clean up after yourselves and remember a clean kitchen is a happy kitchen. Fuck you, Emily. Please also remember any food left in the icebox without a date will be thrown away every Friday evening, so date your food. I don't want to date my food. Welcome to Robco. Greetings, fellow Repcon employees. I'm happy to announce that we have finalized our deal with Robco. Starting tomorrow, we'll be an official Robco facility. Most of you won't notice anything different aside from an increase in benefits. Thank you all for your time. Welcome again to the Robco family. Fuck you, Steve. Blah 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 blah. Dear Robco Supply, first off, let me say that everyone here is really excited about the merger. It's super to be part of a company as exciting as Robco. Have you got some kinks in the supply chain? Yesterday, a bunch of crates got delivered here containing two gross of devices called Stealth Boy. Is it okay if I ask what these things are? Do they really make you invisible? It sounds so wild. Will Robco think of next? Let me know if shipment came here by mistake. I didn't realize my towel is sitting on the back of my chair. I took a shower last night, sat in my computer chair, and apparently I draped my towel over the back of my chair. I just now caught that. Oh, well. So that white thing was behind me, my towel. Always bring a towel. Let me know if the shipment came here by mistake. No problem if it didn't. Bet you can have fun a lot of fun with these things. Private server access. Oh, Robco visit. Steve, please make sure your people are ready for the Robco visit. We're down to negotiating on one project is worth. So the better experiment goes tomorrow, the better for all of us. The reply. I have my team looking into what happened yesterday. I was assured by my best people the experiment would go off without a hitch. We're starting cleanup of the affected area today, but I'm told it may take decades for radiation to clear completely. Just make sure that someone is punished for this. This has significantly reduced our position with Robco. I want them to know that we can keep our house in order. Alright. What was I talking about? Oh yeah. Yeah, so my trips to the US. Always pony stuff. Gotta get it when I can, because it's just easier to get there. This is probably the same terminal, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Just not with all the stuff on it. Plus I had to get shirts that I can actually wear on the screen, because I've got a lot of like green and blue shirts. Which doesn't quite work on the screen behind me. So I needed more shirts that didn't make me disappear. Same terminal. Cake! Stacy, are you kidding me? We've been planning Martin's party for months now and you forgot to order the cake. There's no way we're going to find some place to deliver one out here at this kind of notice. Go to the break room and find something for everyone to eat at the party. Oh dear. She dropped the ball on that one. All in all, it was a really fun vacation. Had a really good time. I was going to try to stream Friday. I had every intention of it. I actually set my alarm for it too. Like, basically, here's what happened. I set my alarm for it, and then I thought there'd be a ghoul here. I set my alarm for it to get up at like 12:30 my time, because I'm up all night, and so I had my alarm set off to go 12:30. Well, 3 in the afternoon, my girlfriend's waking me up. I'm sitting there thinking, what the hell is she waking me up so early for? And it's realized, oh no, it's 3 o'clock. My alarm hasn't gone off, because my alarm was set. It was set off to go at the right time. But my clock on my phone didn't reset time zones. Which is odd. The weather app on it reset itself to the local place, but it did not set my clock. So it was 6 hours behind. So my alarm didn't go off when I wanted it to. And I was, like, I thought, well, I'll do a late stream Friday. But I was just really, really jet-lagged. Martin's retirement. Hey, Gordon, I was surprised, as you were, to hear about Martin's retirement. It seemed that things were going so well. The party sounds like a great idea. I'm sure he'll love to see everyone on his last day. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help. Emily's such a brown noser. But, yeah, and I was, like, jet lag just hit me hard, which is weird because I'm normally not affected by jet lag that much. But for some reason, it just got me hard. So, Friday, I never got around to it. I never even got dressed Friday. So I didn't stream on Friday like I wanted to. So I'm taking all that jet. I need it. I need the jet. Probably. Get up there, though. Um, Yeah, so I ended up Friday. I, like, intended to stream, and I just kept putting it off. Because it was already a late start, and I was still tired. And I didn't get to it. And then I thought, well, Saturday. I thought, Saturday, I'll do, like, an early stream. Because Saturday, of course, season 5 of My Little Pony restarted. It started while I was on vacation, but I caught, like, all the episodes. So I thought, well, I'll do a stream before that starts. I slept in. My alarm went off, but I turned it off and went back to sleep because I was still too tired. And then there pretty much wasn't time after that because, of course, watched the MLP episode. Then it was dinner time because when MLP comes on in the States, it's like 5:30 in the afternoon, 5:30 in the evening here. So, and I watch a live stream of it. Someone live streams it. So then it was dinner time, but the new season of Doctor Who started up. So, and we missed, it started last week, so we missed it while we were on vacation. So it was basically watch MLP, start making dinner, watch last week's episode of Doctor Who, and then immediately after, this week's episode of Doctor Who came on, so we watched that. And then Saturday night, at least for me, it was Saturday night, the third Equestria Girls movie came on, the Friendship Games. That came on like at 2 a.m. for me. So I had to watch that. So basically Saturday was just a complete wash. And then by the time Sunday came, I was like, forget it. I'm taking the whole freaking weekend off. Just, I needed the time to recover. And I was supposed to record when I got back, because there's not a video going out today. All my footage was planned up for Friday. And I thought I was going to record, but just too tired for it. So there's not an episode going up today. Episodes will resume on Wednesday. So yeah, but definitely back for streaming. And actually... one part. I miscalculated. Because on our trip, of course, we were coming back on a Wednesday. Like, our flight out of Florida was on Wednesday. And it was like Wednesday morning. But I didn't actually know, because we had one layover flight. And I didn't actually know our layover flight was 8 hours in Boston. So, you know, we get to Boston, and then we're there till, like, 9 o'clock at night. And then the flight back is, like, 6.5 hours. Storage room terminal. Hi, Steve. We finished converting that old generator room into storage as you requested. You need to have access to the safe password. It is Repcon in Leet speak. Hello, Stevie. Well, I can't say that I'm surprised. You were devious worm when we started here all those years ago. I guess someone has to take the blame. It may as well be your old friend. That waste spill could never have happened if you didn't push the team so hard or if it paid the actual competent personnel. I'll be happy to take my retirement package. Good riddance to you in this forsaken place. So yeah, had an 8-hour layover in Boston, getting on the plane till 9 at night. And so that meant we didn't actually, between the plane overnight, arrival in Amsterdam, then we had to take the train, then we had to take a bus. By the time, so basically we left Wednesday morning. We left early Wednesday morning and didn't get back until Thursday afternoon here. And I had planned on doing my recording on Thursday, but considering I messed up, didn't realize we were going to be an extra day out. I didn't have time. So, plus I was jet lagged crap. So. No recording was done like I planned, unfortunately. I'm kind of disappointed. I did all that planning to make sure there was stuff to go up the 2 weeks I was gone, and I missed the day. I missed one day in the end. Oh well. Hunting revolver. Let's get deeps and damage. Oh fuck, I didn't want to take that. So yeah, there was a miscalculation on my part. Which is also why I didn't, and then, yeah, not streaming on Friday. I wanted to also stream the Monday before I left. I had planned on it, but ended up just too busy. Because we were, like, rushing to make sure everything was ready for us to go, because we left that Tuesday. But I'm back now. I'm back. I'm getting into my regular schedule. This is like the first day back on my regular schedule.
Ready, steady, ready.
There we go. Oh, hey, Chrissy. Yep, today is my first day back on my regular schedule. I intend to keep my regular schedule. It's gonna be back to Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays as usual. I am considering doing extras when I have time. Just because it's Fallout. Basically, it's now the end of September. And I am still not very far into this. I've basically got a month and a half. Holy crap. Kill the Brahmin, no! Basically got a month and a half to finish this before Fallout 4 comes out. So probably if I have time, like in my extra moments, I'll probably do like extra streams. Like, they'll be random though. They'll be just kind of when I have time, when I have a moment. It'll be the normal Monday, Wednesday, Friday schedule, same time. And then like if I do extras, it might be like late one night or one afternoon, or maybe like on a Tuesday or a Saturday or whatever. It just depends. Is this gonna take me forever to get through this? And I got a month and a half to do it. Because I was looking back and I realized it was like, I started playing this at the end of August, wasn't it? It was like, well, it was middle August, I think, that I started this. And it's just gonna take me forever.
Alright, Smoothskin. I'm letting you in. You better watch yourself. I'll sure as hell be watching you.
God, but are you ugly?
Hey!
Get upstairs and talk to Jason before I throw up just from looking at you.
You're not a ghoul, you asshole.
Your pranks won't work on me, Smoothskin. They won't work on Jason either. Stop wasting my time, Smoothskin. Go waste Jason's.
I'll waste you. Call me a Smoothskin. Do I look? I mean, you really call me ugly? I mean, I'm Cyborg Pip at this point, but oh yeah, I think everything's stealing in here. All right, where's Jason? Jason? Just sounds like a Flufflepuff gasp. It's like the Flufflepuff noisemaker. I'm sorry. X, there it is. To find X on my keyboard without looking. Alright. So, I mean, that's pretty much the tale of my trip and everything. To sum it up, rode four-wheeler, shotgun. Not a shotgun, it was a rifle. Had a lot of burgers. Ate Taco Bell. Bought lots of pony stuff. Watched pony. Oh, I played Until Dawn. That was one thing I did. My friend in Florida, his roommate has a PS4 and had Until Dawn. So I played that. That was really fun. Basically, my friend and his roommates had, like, an exclusive Let's Play of, me playing Until Dawn. Guys, hey. Hi.
Sorry. Not now, Smoothskin.
Okay.
Not now, Smoothskin.
How about now?
I don't speak with outsiders. Oh. Smoothskin, sorry. Especially. We don't talk to outsiders. Talk to our leader. Jason, talk to Jason if you have business here. Not now, Smoothskin.
Okay, how about now?
I don't speak with outsiders. Smoothskins, especially. All praise the great journey. All praise the creator's divine will. Hello.
Hi.
All praise the great journey. All praise the creator's divine will.
Okay. You got mentals. We got another Flufflepuff generator over here. Can I use this? What do you guys need Radaway for? Hell's Jason? I like... He's downstairs, isn't he? Rice, Jason, where the hell are you? You're over here. There you are. Is that you? No. Hi. You're a bit, glowy.
Hello, Wanderer.
Whoa.
Please forgive us our humble surroundings. Our true home awaits us in the far beyond. Have you come to help us complete the great journey?
I'm here because, yeah, Faragools are wandering into Novak.
And they've been shooting them down like animals, haven't they? Those ghouls were members of my flock, even after the madness consumed their minds. We never let them wander free. We kept them safe on the first floor. We kept them contained. The demons must have let them out. Somehow. And now they are lost forever, denied the salvation and healing glow of the far beyond. Please, Wanderer, bear in mind that every feral ghoul you spare now is one that we can save later. Once the way is clear, our feral brothers and sisters will accompany us on the great journey. If there are any left.
What is the great journey?
We wish to escape the barbarity of the wasteland, especially the violence and bigotry of its human inhabitants. The Creator has promised to my flock a new land, a place of safety and healing, a paradise in the far beyond. Preparations for the great journey were nearly complete when the demons appeared.
And that's when the Fire Nation attacked, right?
The demons appeared from nowhere. Except it might be more accurate to say they never actually appeared at all. The demons are invisible. Where one of them stands, the most one sees is the air shimmering like sunlight on water. They set upon us as we were on our way to worship one morning. We had just entered the basement. My flock fought bravely and killed a few, but at such cost. Nearly half of us died or went missing. The rest of us retreated up here. One of the demons raved at us, but they have not tried to attack us since. Still, their demonic presence brought all progress towards the great journey to a standstill. But now you have come. Once again, the Creator has sent a human to help us across a seemingly insurmountable obstacle.
Your hair's coming in and out.
Yes, over the intercom. Threats of death should we step outside. Guarantees of safety should we stay locked away. It went on for hours, and did not always make sense. But that was the first day only. Since then, silence. Will you drive away the demons, Wanderer?
Yeah, sure, I'll take care of it.
Praise the Creator. Bless
that hair
you,
under control.
Bless us all. As soon as the underground has been rid of demons, preparations for the great journey can resume.
Yeah, I'm going in the basement. I'm going in the basement. Basement. Alright, down into the basement to find the weird ones. So, I mean, you know, my 2 weeks was good. How was your 2 weeks? How was your time? I know you said kind of eh today. Is it always eh? Or is it just today? Getting ahead of me there. Nightkin? Oh, there's Nightkin in here. Well, that pissed you off, didn't it? Ugh.
Cessation of hostilities complete.
Oh, crap. Oh, good. That, like, froze on me for a second. I'm not actually sure if I did a bad thing by firing first. Frame rate's dying. What's going on? Computer, what are you doing? Stop doing that thing that you're doing. What the hell is going on? To restart my game. My game's acting weird. It's just like suddenly slowing down on me. Oh, I'm going to lock door.
Come and get it.
you picked them. Hey, you're not one of those things out there. Who the hell are you?
Jason sent me.
And I bet he told you it's the creator's will for you to risk your ass instead of him, right? Well, good luck with that. I'd give you a hand, but no thanks. I may look like a corpse, but I'm partial to living. Guess the outfit gives that away, huh? I never did buy into that religious mumbo-jumbo with the robes and all that shit. It gets lonely out in the wastes, okay? And I don't have to tell you, that Bright's group has got some fine-looking goulettes in it. Huh? Or maybe I would have to tell you. Anyway, I helped them out.
I don't judge.
And they kept me supplied with ammo and pleasant company.
How did you end up trapped down
here? First off, I'm not trapped. This was a tactical choice, all right? I'm no match for those things out there. So I found a good defensive position, and I've been defending it, right? Oh, who am I fooling? I'm trapped. Name's Harlan. Pleased to meet you. What
Harlan
happened
Williams?
Was, I was escorting folks down to work when those things attacked us. Most of the fight was upstairs, but some folks panicked and made for the basement. And I went after him. Well, turns out there were even more of those bastards down here than upstairs. And things went to shit fast. I couldn't find the others. So I fell back to this room, set up a nice little kill zone. End of story. I'm not delicate. Rad roach meat for protein. Condensation off the pipes for water. And I do my business over in the far corner. I wouldn't say it's been
the
comfy.
Corner! Alright, how can I get you out of here?
Well, you're polite. I'll give you that. If this was just between you and me, I'd do as you ask. But it's not. I had a friend with me when those mutant bastards came out of nowheres. She panicked and ran the wrong direction. Further into the basement. She's probably dead. But I ain't leaving until I know for sure. I'd have gone looking myself, except I wouldn't last a minute out there. You, on the other hand, seem pretty resourceful. Find my friend, and I'll get out of your way.
I shall find your
Thanks.
Friend.
Let me know what you find out. Here's hoping she's okay.
I will find your friend, because it is magic. Hopefully my game doesn't crash, because it's acting very weird. Alright, you want to talk? Or are we going to fight? Is it going to be a fight?
What's that, Antler?
Okay.
We have a visitor. An assassin, more like. I say kill it, Antler, for safe's sake. Hmm? Okay, Antler, I'll ask. Hi, human. Why you come here?
Right the first time, ugly, I've come to kill you now. Who is Antler?
Who is Antler? Who is Antler?
Yes, who is Antler?
Antler, the human asks about you. What do I tell it? All right. Yes, of course. Who Antler is not important to you. Antler wants that you deal with me.
And who are you?
Me? I am devoted to Antler.
Oh god, we're going
but
in circles.
Before Antler? Captain once. Last name Davison. First name... Don't remember. I commanded a troop of Nikon, the Master's elite. A great honor. Very proud. Something happened. We wandered the desert. Life without Master was... hard. The others' minds going strange. Going crazy. But then, I found us new master. I found us Antler. Since then, everything's been going really well.
Oh, that's good. Maybe I can help.
Good. Antler brought us here for a reason. Why was that, Antler? Right. A piece of paper. Shipment invoice. Hundreds of stealth boys sent here a long time ago. But stealth boys must be in the one room. One we don't search yet. the one we can't search.
Why can't you find it?
A ghoul, but not squishy like others. This ghoul is tough. I thought Antler said, send my kin into that room, but three died. Ghoul is a crackshot and set traps too. After I realized I heard Antler wrong, so I locked the door to keep kin out and wait for Antler to tell me what to do. Then you come along. Antler says you are solution.
All right. I'll find the stockpile for you if you leave this place. You sound a bit strange.
I am in command of my faculties, in command of my troops. Antler guides me in all things, as I in turn guide my kin.
Is Antler that Brahmin skull?
Cut it out, human. Serious. Final warning.
Fine. You're taking orders from a hunk of bone.
A human who is friend to ghouls? Suspicious. You mean the ones upstairs? Antler used intercom, told him stay put, but they want to come down in basement anyways. I cannot allow. My kin are not right in head like I am. They attack you on sight. Ghouls too. They crazy. Your ghoul friends have to wait until you find what Antler brought us to get. Told you already. Antler wants Nightkin to have all the stealth boys in the bad room with the ghoul.
I'll find your stealth boy stockpile for you if your kin will leave this place. Yeah, sure.
Yes, Antler says we leave here as soon as we get stealth boys. Let me give you key. Antler had me lock the door. The ghoul inside.
Oh, I already got it open.
A human. Maybe he don't shoot you. Maybe he will.
All right, so we got a nice little. I'm just gonna take Antler. Can't take Antler. Hi, Davidson. Mind if I search your drawers? You're a big guy. So, I wonder if I can talk to this guy again, or if I just need to find this girl first. Yo!
Did you find my friend? I'm not expecting good news. But keep looking.
Oh.
Bye.
Look, I could work this out. What? You all right? You're fine. Need to be keeping an eye out for the parts. Finish that schematic. Oh, there's a way down. Hell, it's a mess down here. Come on, guys. Keep this place clean. Come on, a clean place is a happy place. Or something like that. I wasn't listening to HR's letter. What is that? Oh yeah, this is like... Isn't this the tunnel to the facility? It is. I'm going down to the facility.
Are we being watched?
Probably. By the way, Suit, you're giving me a wedgie. I don't appreciate it. Yeah, this is either gonna lead me. This, one of them's gonna lead me to the facility, and one of them's gonna lead me to the. Rocket room. Well, that's a fixer upper. This is where all the ghouls want to get to. Rocket facility. What the hell is that? Spacesuit helmet. Sure, I'll take that. Spacesuit. And I'm encumbered. Better. And it can be fixed with the advanced suit. Well, that's good. Fortunately, I'm massively overweight. With all these sparkle polos, holy crap. Mentals, Stimpak, Medics. Apparently I took the wrong way. Think about it. I don't think I've even gone into any like defunct vaults yet. I don't think I've been into a single vault. It's just all been like facilities and places. You wanna do this? Fight. Here, let's see.
Time to fight.
Do you want to fight? Yeah, you want to fight. Oh, that's my face. That's my face, meat. Huh? Alright. They're not going to be nice, so I'm going to have to kill them. Davison's not gonna have any nightkin left by the time I'm done. Whoa!
stuff.
I was about to comment on the number of pilot lights sitting on the floor, but then I was interrupted. Ass. Food. There's food in here. Oh, hi. It's kind of stuck. Crystal has wedged him.
Cessation of hostilities complete.
Ah, there we go. What are stealth boys worth? Not a lot, actually. A Brahmin steak. What do they got? I got in the kitchen. More stealth boys. Oh, there's a sparkle hole in there. And some wine. And they just stripped the flesh off a Brahmin very quickly.
Is cuter, Dr. Klein or Dr. Boros?
They're both dead. I poked them to death with a glove.
Uh-oh.
Your genius is showing. Take him down, Chris. Holy crap, he's got a flamer. You're the jailer.
Hit boy lights on.
Stop it. I need to see things sometimes.
Nobody ever notices me, but they notice the Pip Boy.
I'm trying not to notice you, but you're making it very hard. Bad jail. One of empty cans.
Hit boy lights on.
One of these might be her. In fact, this might be her. Oh dear, that's her. Yeah, that's unfortunate. Her head popped right off. Can't even identify her. That's a shame. Dental prints and even have her jaws blown off. Nothing else down here. There's bad news. The night can kill your girlfriend.
Pip-Boy lights on.
And they blow her head off. Totally happened. Why are you going so slow? Already got the jail key. All right, back up. Back up, back up. Back up we go. Bottles. About your girlfriend, buddy.
Did you find my friend?
Yes.
I see. Well, spare me the details.
No, I'll go into great detail.
I'm gonna miss
her head was in a million bits.
Yellow smile. All right.
Oh, that's gone.
You did your part, so I'll do mine. Look around up here if you want. I'm gonna make a break for topside.
And out for the top, so now I guess we can. Alright, room's clear.
Time to Antler fight. Says,
you what? Are the one. Why?
Antler says.
You bastard! Get him, Chrissy.
That's all.
Why'd you turn on me, you asshole? We could have been friends. I'd have made fun of you quite often. You know what? Fuck Antler. We could have been friends. But now, you're dead. There were traps down here. Are there traps down here? They're gonna blow off all of my face off? That's a trap. Why that's taking so long. Sure how effective bear traps would be against Nightkin. Sure they just step in a bear trap and they just kind of add
Pit
it to-
Pit boy lights on.
Whoa. How did I miss that? That's a bastard thing to do. I could have got hurt on that. All for two stim packs. Oh, there's another. Careful, Chrissy. Careful. Careful, Chrissy. Oh, the computer's rigged too. Do not touch that computer. It's rigged to blow. Whoa. Oh yeah, I've got light step on, so I can't even set these off anyway. I forgot about that. So all these mines I'm not seeing, I wouldn't have set them off anyway. I didn't weigh enough. Or however that skill works. Rad roach me. Oh. Where's the far corner that he does his thing in? There's a big like ghoul poo somewhere in a corner. Crap. Oh, I wonder if he got mad at me for like, I didn't bring him back the thing first. Oh well. Or Nightkin, who cares? To the shipment mistake. First off, let me say that everyone here is really excited about. We already saw this. A bunch of crates delivered. Okay, I saw that. Workplace misbehavior. In light of yesterday's upsetting events, all employees are hereby directed to give a thorough reading to Repcon sexual harassment and workplace behavior policies. Also, while it's not explicitly stated in the employee handbook, unauthorized use of military hardware against fellow employees is ground for immediate termination. Guessing some people probably use the stealth boys to do some things. We're shipping back two crates of devices labeled Stealth Boys back to you. According to the manifest, each crate contained one gross 144 of the devices. As a result, employees' misbehavior, not mine, you little tattletale shithead. One crate was opened and is missing five Stealth Boys. Sorry about that, you little brown noser. Tattling on everyone's fun. Lynch the guy that, like, ratted out people that set the stealth boys back. On dash. I guess that far corner's over there where he does his business. All the 308s are becoming more and more common now. Alright, the stealth boys wouldn't have been here anyway. They got shipped back. There's gonna be like ghoul poo in that corner. That's where he does his business. Or that corner, maybe. Ugh. Be like an Easter egg over here for that. How the hell did you get down here before me? Well, back topside we go. We're done down here. Antler made the Night King go crazy.
Do you like me?
I'm not having this conversation with you anymore. Like, we've been over it. We need to see other undergarments. I think that's really the best thing. Need to not be exclusive like this, you know. I got needs. I need different apparel sometimes. Generator over there. Where are you at, buddy? Oh, hi. There you are. Come back here. I'm not...
Is the way clear?
The Demons are gone.
Praise the Creator, and bless you, Wanderer. The way is clear. I will lead my flock through the basement to the sacred site. I hope you will come find us there, Wanderer. There is much to be done.
I'm not done talking to you.
I apologize, Wanderer, but I must go tend to my flock.
Well, flock away. Flock you, you mother flocker. Flocking about over there. Minding my own flocking business. Means, you know. Still can't get in there. You know what? I want to say what's in the employee thing. Employee terminal. Just that stuff. This is gonna be bad karma if I take the rat away. Nobody's even watching. I wish it was kind of like the Skyrim. You just don't get in trouble as long as nobody sees it. Man, I understand that's not how karma works. Just because nobody's looking doesn't mean you're not gaining bad karma. I took the door right off the frickin' hinges. You guys flocking down here? I heard there's supposed to be a lot of flocking going on. Down here flocking themselves. I mean, I can keep going with these flocking jokes. They're not very flocking good. Pretty flocking terrible, actually. I can keep going. You guys flocking.
I waited to speak with you one last time before I descended to the launch pad, Wanderer. I want you to know that we will remember for all eternity how you delivered us to the threshold of the Great Journey. Our preparations are nearly complete, but the rockets that will carry us to salvation are yet missing vital components. If you would still help us, Wanderer, speak to Chris. He can tell you what is missing. There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always.
Are you seriously going to take your great journey on these rockets?
Yes. The rockets will convey us to our promised land in the far beyond. Vision upon vision has confirmed it. I understand your concerns, friend, and I thank you for voicing them. But the Creator's will for us has been made manifest.
What is the far beyond?
I have glimpsed it only in visions, Wanderer, but what I have seen is truly miraculous. It is a place of light and healing, and I know in my soul that my flock will be safe there.
It's called the sun. You're going to be flying right into the sun.
After all that you have done for us, I suppose you deserve to know everything. When Chris came to us, we tried to convince him that he was human. But this only angered him. He seemed lost. We decided to let him stay with us for a few days, over the course of which we learned that his technical skills far surpassed our own. It became clear that the Creator had sent him to us, to ensure the success of the Great Journey. Equally clear was that Chris should labor in blessed ignorance of his humanity, and his inability to make the journey himself. It is no coincidence that two humans have been vital to the success of the Great Journey. It is my belief that the Creator sent you and Chris to expiate the sins of your kind against mine. Your Redeemers both.
So you're gonna leave Chris behind.
Such is the Creator's will. Vision upon vision has shown me that were Chris to accompany us, he would die in minutes. The radiation around the launch pad alone would kill Chris in minutes. The radioactivity of the far beyond is much stronger.
Well, you really pulled the wool over his eyes.
I take no pleasure in hiding the truth from Chris, but it is the Creator's will.
Bunch of bastards.
To which I must submit.
Goodbye, Jason.
There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always.
Oh, great. Bunch of ghouls on rockets praising my name.
Jason says that I am to cooperate with you on the final tasks necessary to launch the Great Journey. I'm the Flock's resident engineer. I've always been good with machines. Jason says the Great Journey would have been impossible without me. Of course, my skills aren't much use unless I have the right materials. That's where you come in.
Why don't they let you down on the launch pad?
When I joined the Flock, Jason made it clear that he wanted me to supervise the repairs, not do them myself. It would be a waste of my gifts to work on just one system at a time. From up here, I've been able to supervise the entire project.
The radiation would kill you, Chris, because you're human.
I thought we were past all that, Smoothskin. But you just can't resist the chance to mess with me. Typical human. I was human once, you know. Grew up in Vault 34, northeast of here. Nice upbringing if you like assault rifles and target practice. But oh, you prefer machines that don't shoot people? Not so nice then. Who should maintain the vault's reactor? Hauser? Mitchell? No, make it Haversome. He likes machines. Haversome won't mind getting irradiated. Haversome won't mind mutating. He's already ugly as it is. Haversome won't mind when his hair starts falling out after a few years. There's no connection, Haversome. You're neurotic.
That's a different kind of hair falling out.
Bald? You call this bald, Smoothskin? I'm a monster. A monster!
Oh, we can get the Black Widow thing. Honey, you're no monster. You're cute. Wow, I could just about eat you up.
Stop making fun of me! But you're telling the truth, aren't you? Oh no. How could they do this to me? For 2 years? My god, I've been a joke to them. Do you have any idea how easy it'd be for me to sabotage those rockets? That'd be a joke, huh? One hell of a joke.
That would be murder, Chris. Oh, good sabotage. Well, I don't think they're gonna make it anyway.
What, you think I'm too stupid to pull it off?
A little bit.
I know enough to get their rockets working, don't I? So I can make them fail, too.
Not that that's a big accomplishment. I mean, I could walk onto a rocket launch pad and make it fail. And I could do so without doing very much. So his big, hey, I'm so smart I can sabotage a rocket. Well, so can a squirrel high on coffee and heroin. It's not a matter of smart, you'd never forgive yourself.
Like I could forgive myself for getting duped like this? They used me, and now they'll throw me away.
They'd take you if you could, Chris.
And dying would be worse than this? Used up and thrown away like garbage?
Yeah, that's right. You're trash. They're going to revere you as Saint Chris. You want to be Saint Chris, right?
Oh. So I've redeemed the human race, is that it? What a crock. The human race can't stand me.
Yeah, I can't imagine why. You're... You're all right, Chris. You're all right. God, I hate your face.
So, you want me to accompany you on your adventures across the wasteland?
Oh, fuck no. No, 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 no. Wait, how did you jump to that conclusion?
Life among humans again? That's what you're suggesting?
Or the Brahmin. There's Brahmin there, too, if you want to, you know.
I guess it's the only chance I've got.
What do you want to do?
I can't believe I'm agreeing to this, but I'll give it a try. I'll get Jason and his flock on their way, and then I'll head for Novak.
What you doing there? You don't use a wrench on that. Why are you using a wrench on that? I totally want his sweet, sweet candy booty. I mean, come on, what do you think?
Pip-Boy lights on.
Not much of an ass there.
Are you ready to get started? Those rockets aren't going to launch themselves. I was close to completing work on the rockets before we were driven into hiding on the top floor. Two components were missing. A quantity of isotope 239 igniting agent, and a set of thrust control modules. The igniting agent is highly radioactive and decays quickly. That's why we can't use the drums that leak down on the launch pad. It's no longer potent enough. I need you to find an intact, shielded container of the igniting agent. As for the thrust control modules, they were custom built for these rockets. They won't even launch without them.
I'll get the igniting agent.
Very well. We don't need a huge amount. 2 to 3 liters should be enough.
Oh, the rocket souvenirs.
Yes, that's isotope 239, all right. And there's enough here to launch the rockets. Now all I need is the thrust control modules. Repcon has been ransacked so many times by scavengers, it's hard to know where the components might turn up. If they turn up. Jason has mentioned some industrial ruins to the east that are supposed to be highly radioactive. Scavengers wouldn't know the value of the modules just by looking at them. If you know any junk dealers in the area, I'd start there. Later.
Time to go. Alright. What are you guys doing now? Oh, you're... You know, what is that guy doing? Just monitoring the spills, apparently. I know it's radioactivity, but why aren't you guys, like, cleaning that mess up? Guiding me to go. It's probably just guiding me to go out the same way. Just as easy to get out through here. Oh, Helios 1. Get a really damn good weapon at Helios 1. If you do it right. I'll be honest, I don't remember how to do it. I think I can probably do it, though. Pretty sure. Oh, what was the way out of here? There's a way up there I couldn't get to. So we get to run that Helios 1. Or maybe not run, just move at a slightly brisk pace. I head back to Novak, see if I can sell some stuff off. I'm weighted just a little bit. Buddy, what are you doing? Floating? Stop trying to be that guy. Just floating there. Even your bits are floating. Come on, get down. Get down.